I know a lot of us have long battles with our own weight, but imagine trying to get everyone you know, not just to eat healthy, but to use healthy food to change entire communities. This whole story, it's amazing. This started back in 1993 with a greenhouse. First saw it in 1990, if I'm correct. This whole organization called Growing Power, which now provides enough vegetables and fish every year, really to feed thousands upon thousands of people. It is run by former pro basketball player Will Allen, who wrote about his passion and his grassroots movement in this new book. It's called The Good Food Revolution. And Will, good morning.
Good morning. It's great to be here,
Brooke. Great to have you here. You write this, I'm fascinated by just really your family story, which is sort of how you begin the book, telling the story about your mother, who was a sharecropper in South Carolina, who, you know, as part of the Great Migration said, I don't want any part of this life. I want to leave, you know, and head to Washington, D.C. And here you are returning to the roots of your mother that she wanted to leave.
Yeah, and I had a similar story because I grew up on a farm right outside of Washington, D.C. And when I was 18, I had about 100 scholarship offers at different universities.
Wow.
And at that point, when I left to go to University of Miami, where I became the first African-American basketball player there, I said, never again will I do this farming. So you probably should never say never.
I was about to say, never say never. So you end up playing basketball. You wind up playing basketball in Belgium.
Yes.
And that's when your passion for farming, I don't want to say reignited, I guess it's ignited for the first time. Tell me about what happened there.
Well, one of my Belgian teammates, a family had a farm, and that I went out one day and I helped them plant some potatoes. And once I touched the soil, something really came alive. I really wanted to start growing food again. So I must have had some hidden passion that was reunited,
lurking,
like you said.
Deep down.
Yeah, so from that point on, I wanted to grow food, and I started over in Belgium, actually.
But then you brought it to the Milwaukee area.
Right. When I came back, I wanted a farm, but I had to have an off-farm job, and I worked for the Marcus Corporation and then Procter & Gamble. And in 1993, I was driving down the street on one of my Procter visits to a store, and I ran across this vacant piece of property, an old greenhouse operation, and the city owned it. And to make a long story short, I was able to make the purchase and really start the journey.
So what we have, and great to see you, and I remember our last conversation about this, there's the struggle here is that as an African-American migration went to the north, and just generally the way we live in cities, these are food deserts.
Right.
And you were trying to, you ultimately have tried to change that environment.
Well, what typically happened back in those days, and it happened with my parents, but for some reason my father wanted me and my brothers to learn about where our food came from, and for practical reasons that we didn't have a lot of spendable income, so we grew about 95% of the food that we ate.
Wow.
So I'm now using those skills to teach others, because we're in a situation now where obesity is at all-time high. One out of three of us, supposedly, by statistics, are obese, and by 2030, 42% of Americans, if we don't change the way we eat our food and, you know, our our structure of our system is that if two-thirds is based on nutrition, and the other two, of course, is stress management
and
exercise. So if we're able to get that two-thirds fixed, we'd have a healthier communities and a healthier nation.
So what would you say is the goal 10 years, 20 years out for the good food revolution?
Well, I think it's reached that revolutionary stage. It was a movement, but thousands and hundreds of thousands of people, and it really, really ramped up a few years ago when First Lady Michelle Obama put the small garden on the White House lawn. They estimate that 10 million people started growing food. And many people of color went back into growing food.
How can other communities do this, though? Take what you've done in the Milwaukee area and do it elsewhere to feed those who need it.
Well, we're training thousands of people. Each year we train over 1,000 farmers. We have workshops from January throughout the year, and national conferences. We'll have a 3,000-person national, international conference on urban agriculture and small farms in September 7th, 8th, and 9th in Milwaukee. And I hope the book really teaches younger people, especially high school and college age folks, about the history and the legacy of what happened during the great black migration to the South, because much of the skills sets were left, and for obvious reasons, African-American folks that knew a lot about growing food, over 300,000 were farmers at one time. Now we have less than 18,000 African Americans that are farming in this country. Didn't pass on to the several generations, and we're paying for it as we look at this food deserts. And
but you're passing it on. You're passing it on now that so much of this book is how you did it down to the soil, but also how, you know, these greenhouses and these farms for you have really become safe shelters for so many young people in the community. So I commend you for that. You're an inspiration. It's the Good Food Revolution. Will Allen, thank you so much.
Thank you
pleasure
very
meeting
much,
you.
Brooke.
And we'll
it's
be back
to,
in just a moment.
Good to see you all.